This YCN segment is brought to you by H.R. Clough and Kearsarge Heating, your local energy specialist.
Welcome back. YCN Sports Talk, Jeremy Stout, Brett Franklin in studio, and we move over to the baseball diamond. Red Sox, Yankees in the midst of their second three-game series, round two, this time in the Bronx. And last night, a tough loss for the Red Sox. Good starting pitching. We'll get to that. But this series, we expected to see the Yankees. I mean, they've been playing really well. It's not like the Yankees the first time we saw them.
Yeah, you know, and I don't think the Yankees have played their best baseball. I know it's hard to say, but they, you know, they last night, some defensive woes, bad base running, but you got some great starting pitching. You were able to get Aaron Judge at the plate last night with the bases loaded, comes through with a big hit. But, I mean, I expect these teams to go back and forth all summer long. You know, the Yankees had that slow start. We both thought that they would eventually snap out of it, which they've done. But this is great for baseball. When both of these teams are winning, when both of these teams are in the hunt for a division title, that is good for baseball. And the biggest thing here for both of these teams is to avoid playing that one-game wild card. I think more so for the Red Sox than for the Yankees. But this is going to be a fun season. And last night had a playoff-type atmosphere to it. Luis Severino pitched great for the Yankees. Drew Pomeranz, who I thought was going to bail early in that in that game due to the injury, he grinded it out. Gutsy performance from him. It was a great baseball game. Had that September-like feeling.
Yeah, and it's going to be like that, it seems like, every game that these two teams play, because I really believe it's going to come down to that last weekend of the regular season when these teams play three at Fenway Park. You mentioned the starting pitching. Drew Pomeranz, a good bounce-back start. He looked a little bit better in his last start, but I think it was against the Royals. Now he does it against the Yankees. Starting pitching as a whole, especially with the news about David Price, a little bit on edge right now for the Red Sox.
Yeah, and I'm sure we'll get to the David Price thing here in a moment. But, yeah, I mean, I thought Drew Pomeranz pitched great last night. Again, had the thumbnail issue and fingernail issue, whatever it was, and he gutted it out. I mean, and gave the team a chance to win. And, you know, first home run he gave up to Stanton, I thought was, you know, typical Yankee Stadium. It's a band box, you know, really a line drive dart. I mean, that's a single at Fenway Park, and I know Fenway's a little bit different than most parks. But I thought Pomeranz pitched great. I mean, that's encouraging sign to see what he gave you at the Bronx last night.
And we had Chris Sale pitching the last game on Sunday, pitching really well. We had talked about him not being as sharp as he could be, but Sunday, 12 strikeouts, gets the win. Pomeranz looks good. Rick Porcello, who was bumped up to tonight, I believe, due to the injury, he's looked good. So now we get to that injury of David Price. He's sent back to Boston. So this isn't even a situation where we're going to go a couple days and see what happens. This is almost like we are at, you know, code red right now.
It's not good. You know, and again, he had pitched, you know, kind of had some ups and downs here the last four games, but I don't think there was anything of nerves here for the Red Sox. But, yeah, I don't have a good feeling on this. And, you know, the reason why Rick Porcello, I feel, is pitching better than he is even in 2016 is because of the fact the pressure's not on him. Right. You know, Chris Sale's the number one. David Price has been pitching well at number two, and Porcello can be what he is, a number three, and he's been good so far. You know, I hate to say it, but if the Red Sox don't have Price pitching at his full potential, and I know he's not a postseason guy, I don't think they win the World Series. And, you know, it's really hard to even get to a pennant.
Right, because the way that Price pitches so well when he's on, as we saw at the beginning of this season, I mean, like you said, the last few outings kind of been a little down in the velocity, and he struggled a little bit. But when we saw him when he was on at the beginning of the season, he's really good. And as is this Red Sox offense, this Yankees offense, both these teams, we've seen about 20% of the season now. We've had a good look. I know some of the competition hasn't been great either way, but are you reevaluating any of these things that you said at the beginning of the season?
I think the offense is better than what we had expected. Obviously, you know, guys like J.D. Martinez, you know, a free agent coming in, you know, and as we've talked about on the radio, you know, I felt that he doesn't have that much pressure that most free agents would have, and that's allowed him to get out of that early funk and be able to hit. You look at guys like Mookie Betts, big triple last night. You got to imagine he's going to continue that consistency. What do you get from Xander Bogaerts? I think the other big thing that they have to address is, you know, what do you do with Jackie Bradley Jr.? Is his defense worth the sacrificing of the offense moving this season? He's now 1 for 23 getting that hit last night. So things will need to, I'm curious if things will change and how much Alex Cora rides this wave of success so far. He's had the magic touch.
Yes, looked good. And quickly before we hit the break, Red Sox-Yankees London series announced for next year. Red Sox will be the home team, so they'll lose a couple home games. Do you like that, going over to London?
No, I hate it. I hate it. I don't like it. Keep the game here in the U.S. I just hate, same with football, right. And I get it, it's trying to get the world outreach, but maybe play a game, in Latin America or go back to Puerto Rico. I mean, London, I don't really think that's a big market you're looking to hit for Major League Baseball, but I thought they were cricket fans.
Yeah, they are. And they did play the game in Mexico, I think, last week or Sunday, but it will be interesting. Red Sox, Yankees, and I don't like the Red Sox losing two home games.
No.
They got a home field advantage. That's kind of big, I think. I know there's 81 of them, so what's two more, but whatever. We'll take our final break. We'll come back, talk some football, make our Salt Hill Pub picks of the week. You're watching YCN Sports Talk.